Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding stateless and left out at sea, written by a beautiful lady, Naveen Murshid. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very, very important from your interview point of view also. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to go in the background. We need to understand the history of this conflict. The conflict between the state of Myanmar and the ethnic community of the Rohingya Muslims. Why there has been a kind of acrimony? Why the state and the Rohingyas, they have actually become incompatible? So we all need to understand this by understanding the history of this conflict. Now as far as Myanmar is concerned, earlier it was known as Burma, and the Britishers, they have fought a war with the Burma, and Burma was included in their entire Indian subcontinent occupancy. So it was also under the suzerainty of the imperialism. So during the imperialistic era, Burma and Myanmar, it was also affected by it. And during those days, because this entire continent, Indian subcontinent, from Afghanistan to Pakistan to India to Sri Lanka to Myanmar to Nepal, all this region, it was under the suzerainty of the Britishers. There was no boundary, there was no kind of a stoppage. So the Britishers, what they had done at that point of time, they have actually caused the out migration of the Muslims, Rohingya Muslims, only the Muslims, from the Bangladesh region to the Myanmar region of Arakan. Now if we want to understand about the region in which they are staying, these Muslims which are fighting with the state of the Myanmar, we need to decipher it from the map. Now this is how the Myanmar actually looks like. This is a rough map of Myanmar, and this is the part, Arakan map. This is the region in which the Muslim population is residing. Predominantly it is a Buddhist nation. So most of the people who are residing in Myanmar, they practice Buddhism. Now there is a fight between the Rakhine Buddhists and Rohingya Muslims. Now these two ethnic groups, they are actually fighting with each other. Now what is the cause of the fight? The first reason of the fight is the ethnic difference between these two communities. One is a Buddhist, the other one is a Muslim. So this sits in the incompatibility between both these two communities. Now the other reason why there has been so much of abhorrement, there is so much of incompatibility. Now the biggest reason is, when Myanmar was under the suzerainty of the Britishers, there was a movement going on in Myanmar for its independence, and this Rohingya Muslims, they had actually supported the Britishers. So the seeds of acrimony between the nationalist forces of the Myanmar and between the Muslims, they had actually been sown during the phase of the fight for independence of Myanmar. Jab azadi ki ladai lad raha tha Myanmar, us time pe jo Rohingya Muslims hai, they have actually sided with the Britishers. And when they sided with the Britishers, they were actually supposed to fight against the Japanese imperialistic forces. But this was not done by the Rohingya Muslims. Instead, they had used all their force to wipe the villages, the Buddhist villages in the Arakan region. So, यहाँ पे बहुत अत्याचार किया था Rohingya Muslims ने. And why there is a conflict? Now, why this conflict incompatibility? It has risen to the highest of the levels. It has risen to the highest of the levels now because these Rohingya Muslims, they claim that they are the indigenous group, they are the indigenous people of this Myanmar region of Arakan, and they had also built up their army, they had also built up their agenda, they had also built up their plan for a separate state. So in the past, the Rohingya, they have also resorted for a secessionist movement. They wanted that a separate Muslim nation should be created in this region. And it is because of that we have the lot of incompatibility. This is the third factor. And when Myanmar got its independence, and at the same time when Indian Pakistan also got its independence, this region was propelled by the Muslim League to be included in the domain of Pakistan. But that was not done at that point of time because of the pressure that was exerted by the Myanmar government at that point of time. And Myanmar at that point of time was under the military rule. Now, the Rohingyas, they claim that this part in which they are residing right now, it was ruled by a Muslim king about 400 to 500 years back. And this is their natural territory. This is their home territory. They are not somebody who have come out from the other part to get settled here. They belong to this land, and because of that, they have every right to stay here. But the truth is that most of the Muslims, they have actually moved from the region of Bangladesh to this Myanmar. Now these are the regions of the incompatibility between the Rakhine Buddhists and the Rohingya Muslims. They have basically propagated this term Rohingya in order to assert to the world about their birthplace being the place where they are currently staying, that is in the Arakan region. So this is all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. And you can contact me at 84594-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. You can also install my application. Name of the application is BrainyKey. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And question for the day is, critically analyze the ongoing conflict in Myanmar. And write this answer in 200 words. Click and send me on my WhatsApp number 84594-000. So this is all for the day. In case you like this video, please click on the like button and do share and comment on this video. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice.